go. Rules of someone else's game. Okay, all right, start again. Are you ready, Patrick?
Yep.
Okay. Something has changed. What? Oh, yes, hold on. Okay, is this okay? Okay, Patrick, you're very patient. Oh, okay. Sooner flying, defying gravity. Patrick, I think I'm off! Yep, yep. Okay. The video is buffering. Pat?
All right, very nice, Frankie.
Was that, did I go too far with the commentary about was that too far? I have opinions, Pat. I'm opinionated. It is mine. It's my puppet opinion. So, suck it.
Mother Bruce by Ryan T. Higgins. Bruce was a bear who lived all by himself. He was a grump. He did not like sunny days. He did not like rain. He did not like cute little animals. Bruce only liked one thing, eggs. He collected them from all over the forest.
Good morning, Mrs. Sparrow.
Bruce didn't eat eggs raw like other bears. Instead, he cooked them into fancy recipes he found on the internet. One day, Bruce came across a recipe for hard-boiled goose eggs drizzled with honey salmon sauce. So, he went out to get the ingredients. First, he caught a few salmon. Then, he collected honey from a local beehive. He liked to support local business, you see. Last, he went to Mrs. Goose's nest to pay her a visit.
Are these eggs free-range organic?
At home, Bruce prepared the eggs for hard boiling. But the fire in his stove fizzled, so he went out to get more wood. When Bruce came back, he was met with an unwelcome surprise. Bruce became the victim of mistaken identity. Bruce wanted hard-boiled eggs, not goslings. He supposed he could settle for buttered goslings on toast, but for some reason he lost his appetite.
I will have to ask Mrs. Goose about her return policy.
Bruce scooped up the little geese and stomped back to their nest, only to find Mrs. Goose had flown south early. Bruce left the goslings there anyway and went back home. But he was followed. Bruce was very stern and said things like,
"Go away!"
And,
"I am not your mother."
And also,
"I liked you better when you were eggs."
Bruce could take it no longer. He became extra grumpy with them. It didn't work. Goslings always follow their mother, even if she is a he, and he is a bear. Bruce was stuck with them. He tried to make the best of it. It was hard work. As the seasons passed, Bruce watched the pesky goslings grow older.
Annoying baby geese. Stubborn teenage geese. Boring adult geese.
Then one fall afternoon, he saw other goose families flying south. Finally, he'd be rid of these geese. And he could take a long winter's nap. Bruce explained migration. But they didn't listen. Bruce needed these geese to leave, so he got creative. Nothing worked. The geese would not leave Bruce. So Bruce decided to pack some bags and take the geese into town. They boarded a bus and migrated to Miami. Now every winter, Bruce and his geese head south together. They laze about at the beach in tacky shirts, sipping ice-cold lemonade, while Bruce dreams of new recipes. Recipes that don't hatch. The end.
This is What About Us, originally done by Pink. La 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 la. We are searchlights, we can see in the dark. Rockets pointed up at the stars. We are billions of beautiful hearts. And then you sold us down the river too far. And what about us? What about all the times you said you had the answers? And what about us? What about all the broken happy ever after? What about us? What about all the plans that ended in disaster? What about us? What about trust? What about to be solved? We are children who need to be loved. We were willing, we came when you called. But man, you fooled us. Enough is enough. Here's the big note. What about us? What about all the broken happy ever after? Oh, what about us? What about all the plans that ended in disaster? What about love? And what about trust? What about us? Here's the dance solo. Ready?
I silently listen to the pain as she sits elaborating on her experience as a black woman living in the suburbs. My world is white, she says, as the sun reflects in the lens of her glasses. She is smiling as she looks me in the eye as I uncomfortably laugh. Her smile wipes away. It's not a joke. It's my reality. My world is white. I live in a pale municipality. My lovers are white. My neighbors are white. All my friends, they're white. My world is white. I have a sinking feeling in my gut as I quickly run through in my mind the lengthy list of problematic situations a black person would face isolated with only whites in Massachusetts in a racially divided America. The uncomfortable silence from friends that don't know what to say or may not be ready to face the disgusting, shameful, horrifying truths about what America really stands for. Land of the free? Land we stole from natives? We are home of the brave? We are a nation built by slaves, and perhaps we have kept them down because we are afraid that what they seek will be revenge. I would not blame them. They deserve justice. They deserve peace. They deserve prosperity. They deserve to be free of the atrocities that our police mobs have caused, exploiting not only the people but our laws to obtain immunity. They are going to have a mutiny on their hands, and I, for one, welcome it. Because after the revolution, when the dust clears, I want my ears to hear my love say, my world is vibrant with color, and I feel safe in this rainbow world with you.
Up next on Charlie's Quarantine Corner, Charlie puts the spotlight on someone she loves in this week's InterZoom. Get it? Like an interview, but over Zoom? Sort of a play on words, you know, just forget it. Just play the clip.
Hello and welcome to this week's InterZoom. I am here today with Mike Gowing. Mike, how are you today?
I'm really well. How are you doing, Charlie?
I'm well, thank you. One of the things that made me feel really welcome when I started working at ActonTV was just meeting you. You're a really bright and bubbly person and you're really fun to talk to. And I love that we have in common a love of raptors. Is that what they're called? Like, I just really like birds of prey. That's what I always call them. But when I say raptor, I think a dinosaur. Can you tell me about how your passion for raptors began?
Sure. First of all, raptor is a Latin word, comes from the Latin word rapere, which means to grab or seize. And raptors typically, because they're carnivorous, have to hunt small prey. They have talons as opposed to claws. They have to be able to seize their prey and hold on to them and oftentimes lift them away from the ground. They have forward-focused eyes. Okay. Prey typically have eyes on the sides of their head, like a squirrel, or whereas raptors, which for the purposes of what we're talking about, are eagles, hawks, falcons, owls.
I didn't know an owl was a raptor. Okay.
Yeah. Osprey, vultures, kites are all raptors. They are all carnivores, and they all share these same traits. A couple of sources that I found are really helpful. One is the Cornell University Lab of Ornithology. Ornithology is the science of birds. And another is the Audubon Society. They have a website as well. So you can go into either of those. Both have live cams on raptors' nests. So you
are they wild nests though, or is it
nests? No. These are wild nests. They'll find them in the woods, and they'll set up these cams and just kind of monitor the progress of the chicklets being born and the parents feeding them.
And you showed me the picture of the Cooper's hawk you found. Was that in your backyard?
Yep, I have a slider, and that was literally 5 feet from my slider. I took that picture through my slider. So it was in January.
I also saw the picture of the bald eagles at the pond as well. And is that's in Acton, right?
Yes, yep. That's in North Acton, right on Route 2A. The reservoir, it's Concord's reservoir, but it's called Nagog Pond. and there's a mated pair that live there. So.
And this, and that, so is that a nest that they, like, they know where it is? Like, they don't have a camera on that one, do they?
They know where it is, yeah. But it's over near the Concord, it's private property. It's Concord's water treatment plant. I tried to get ActonTV to be able to go out there, but again, in order to get to the nest, you had to trespass on Concord's land.
That's easier to do as an individual. Than
exactly. I can't.
So maybe I'll find some footage for you. I'm like, I'm pretty sure what I saw was an eagle hunting, and it must have been a mouse because it was like in the middle of like a big field.
Right.
That was legitimately one of the coolest things I've ever seen in my life. I'm just such a nature person, and it's I'm like very peaceful by nature, but you know, a bird's got to eat. So
nature isn't peaceful.
I went to I don't know what it was. It was like a presentation at the Chelmsford Library at one point, and it was this woman who was teaching how to bird watch like a type of sparrow. And I guess there's another type of sparrow that like migrated here, like by humans, like humans brought them here in their predatory. And this sweet woman was just like, and in order to keep our sparrows, like the local ones, you take this one and you break its neck. And I was just like, what? Like, I was mortified. But the more she was talking about it, she was like, you really have to, because the, in order, and I don't know that, I've never broken a bird's neck in my life, but it was really fascinating to just hear all the facts about it and how the local birds are becoming endangered because of
those are invasive species, and we see it more with plants than we see it with animals. But there are invasive fish that have been brought in from Asia that will clear out the indigenous population and take it over. They're very aggressive. There are groups that want to make sure that the bird species stays around.
Indigenous, yeah. It's really important. I'm so glad that bald eagles aren't on the endangered list anymore. They really
they've come off. And part of what has affected the bald eagles and many other raptors is the use of pesticides.
Yes.
Because when they eat animals that have ingested pesticides, it ends up in them, and then they may die from it. Because nobody wants to go the way of the dodo.
Right.
but birds in general, both raptors and prey, are fun to watch. They're really interesting for kids. Kids learn a lot about, you know, nature, how they raise their young, how they migrate.
And now that I'm homeschooling my kids, you have totally inspired me. I think I'm going to use bird watching as a way that we can kind of have.
Well, and the other thing is, it's even if you can't get out, even if you're COVID bound, as they say, if you get kids involved early on, remember birds come in such a variety of colors, and when they start to learn the names and they start to understand the sounds that they make, where you'll be outside and the first time your daughter says, that's a blue jay, or from the north, you know, from their cry, then you'll be impressed.
And my kids are way smarter than I am, so they'll catch on before I do. Thank you so much for talking with me today.
You're very welcome, Charlie, and good luck with your show.
Thank you.
I hope I've encouraged people to become bird watchers. It's a lot of fun.
Thank you so much.
The name on everybody's lips is gonna be Charlie. The person raking in the chips is gonna be Charlie. I'm gonna be a celebrity, that means somebody everyone knows. They're gonna recognize my eyes, my hair, my teeth, my boobs, my nose. From just some dumb mechanic's wife, I'm gonna be Charlie, who says that murder's not an art, and who, in case she doesn't hate, can say she started with a bang. Charlie Smith. That's me, mother.
this is the part where a bunch of men carry me around. It'll be great. I want lesbians there too. I'll have them all. Boys and girls, they're gonna wait outside 6 feet apart to get to see Charlie. Think of those autographs I'll sign. Good luck to you, Charlie. And I'll appear in a lavalier that goes all the way down to my waist. Here a ring, there a ring, everywhere a ring-a-ling, but always in terrible taste. I'm a star, and the audience on Zoom loves me, and I love you all. And I love them for loving me. And I love them for loving me. I said that wrong, that's weird. And we love each other. And that's because none of us got enough love in our childhoods. And that's showbiz. I spoke too quickly, kid. She's giving up her humdrum life. I'm gonna be singing, Charlie. She made a scandal and a star.
Please, hold your applause, because I can't hear it anyway. Ah.